This evening, as I was preparing to come here, I was praying and asking the Lord, and just praying for this evening's meeting, asking the Lord to speak and make himself known. And as I was praying, I saw the heavens open, and I was taken before the presence of the Lord, and this is what he said. A second American Revolutionary Civil War is coming. The very thing that is prophesied by Rick Joyner. The Lord specifically told me his name. He said this was shown to him and he has prophesied that. So go and read what he has written about a second American Revolutionary Civil War. It is so appropriate. We are not here in this place, Gettysburg, by coincidence, because this is where the Civil War took place. Uh-huh. And the word of the Lord comes to you, a second American Revolutionary Civil War is coming. Again, let me repeat, this was prophesied by Rick Joyner. He was shown in a vision, was shown dreams about that, how it will come and what to do. I encourage you to go and read his magazines, read his books, because he has received that revelation in greater detail. I'm just giving you an executive summary. Now, what is this civil war? This war is against Christians and against their liberties. Brother will turn against brother. Father against his son. And mother against her daughter. Your own family will become enemies. And the Lord Jesus Christ prophesies this in Mark chapter 13 verse 12. And Luke chapter 21 verse 16. Now what shall we do? This is coming. I pleaded before the Lord, like I always do. Lord, is there a way out? What should your people do? So the Lord gave four counsels. Four things. Number one, pray that you don't lose your religious liberty. Pray ardently. Pray sincerely. Your very life depends on that. Individually, in prayer groups, gather together in your homes, gather like-minded Christians together in your home, or like what our ministry does in the US. My associate here, stand up, John and Bonnie. These are my associates in the US. They live in Moravian Falls. And they maintain a prayer line. Is it every Tuesday? Every Thursday, a network of intercessors connect together through Skype. And they all intercede and pray. So you can do something like that. You do that too? Oh, wonderful. Just like that. See, like-minded Christian. There's one group here. You can do the same thing. Uh-huh. Maybe after this meeting, you can ask them how they do. And you can form a group and pray together. See, one will put 1,000 to flight. Two will put 10,000 to flight. So pray ardently that you don't lose your religious liberties. Number two, pray that you will escape from all this wrath to come. Pray that you escape. Escape meaning, it can mean two things. Taken out of this or hidden. Hidden somewhere. Number three, pray for your children and protect them from indoctrination of evil ways. In Sweden, they have now make it mandatory that every child that goes to kindergarten should be taught that he's not a male or female. Huh. It's mandatory, you know. It's 3 years old, 5 years old. They are told, you think you are male? No. You think you're a female? No. You may become a female. You may become a male. Or you can become a drag queen. Or you may not even know who you are. little ones.
Confusion.
And they will grow up with that thinking, what will they become? A nation of gays. Now, such education is spreading all over the world right now. All over the world. Even in the US, it has begun. So pray that your children will be protected from such indoctrination of evil ways. And number four, fast and pray that you will stand strong against the evil days. That you stand strong. No matter what happens, you will stand strong. I strongly feel in my spirit right now that the Lord Jesus Christ is putting his two hands over his face and weeping over the US like how he wept over Jerusalem. And I hear the Holy Spirit tell me, Son of Man, no matter how much you shouted and cried to them, they are dull of hearing. They will leave this place and go back on their own ways.
Jesus, God have mercy.
And the Lord Jesus Christ is asking you a question now. Is there faithful remnant here? Is there anyone who will stand in the gap before me and take my hand and plead for their nation? Is there anyone who will throw himself before my face and groan for the sins of the land? Is there anyone who will groan and weep for the sins that are taking place in the churches and the ministers? Is there anyone? If you can say, I am the one, Lord, then drop to your knees right now. If you want to prostrate yourself, go ahead. Now you cry out to God. You pray for your nation. I'm not asking you to pray for India. I'm not asking you to pray for any other nation. For your own nation. The United States of America. For your children. For your churches. I see the Lord Jesus Christ as the Son of Man, greatly sorrowful, walking in our midst right now. Tear your heart, my dear brothers and sisters, my dear sons and daughters, tear your heart. And you cry out right now. You cry unto him. Pray that you don't lose your religious liberties. Pray that you will escape from all the wrath to come. Pray for your children. Pray for the sins of the land. Plead the sins of the justices of the Supreme Court who passed the same-sex marriage bill. Pray against all the evil lawmakers in the land that are devising wicked legislation to be implemented in the land. Like what California is trying to do. Tear your heart. Tear your heart and you weep. You cry unto God right now. Cry for His mercies.